All right, let's be real for a second. You ever look back at life and think, man, I wish someone had told me that sooner? Well, buckle up, because today I'm spilling the tea on life lessons people learn way too late. And trust me, some of these will make you rethink everything. And hey, before you say, nah, I've got life figured out, guess what? You don't. And that's okay. I didn't either. So let's dive into the hard truths, the good laughs, and the stuff no one else will tell you, but should have. 1. Your job doesn't define you. Let me start with something that might get a few people riled up. Your job does not define you. Yeah, I said it. I know society's out here telling us that your value is tied to your title. Oh, you're a lawyer? Must be so successful. Wait, you're a barista? Hmm, cute side gig. Ugh, can we not? Here's the hard truth. If your entire sense of self is wrapped up in your job, you're setting yourself up for disappointment. Jobs come and go. Some of them are amazing, some of them suck the soul out of you, but none of them define who you are as a person. There was a time when I was totally guilty of this. I worked in a high-pressure job, good title, decent pay. And guess what? I was miserable. But I clung to it because I thought, well, this is who I am now. This is what people will respect me for. Spoiler alert. Nobody cares about your title when you're drowning in stress, skipping lunch to make deadlines, and hating your life. Now I'm doing something completely different, and here's the kicker. I'm way happier, even though my new job isn't something that would wow people at a dinner party. And you know what? I don't care anymore, and that's the freedom I want you to experience. Oh, what do I do for a living? I'm a professional badass who values peace of mind. How about you? Honestly, that's how we should be introducing ourselves. No one should have to list a job title to prove their worth. You're worth more than the number on your paycheck or the fancy name on your business card. You're worth the way you treat people, the passions you pursue, and how you live your life. Let me take it one step further. Obsessing over your job is a distraction. It's a way of avoiding the stuff that really matters. Yeah, I said it. When you're so consumed with climbing the career ladder, sometimes you forget to ask yourself, wait, am I actually happy? Or am I just chasing status? Here's the thing. Your job can be a part of you, but it's not all of you. You are a whole person, with dreams, relationships, and a life outside of work. I realized this when I had a wake-up call. One day I looked in the mirror and asked myself, if I wasn't doing this job, would I still like who I am? And honestly, the answer was no. That was the moment I knew something had to change. So if you're in a job that doesn't bring you joy, or you're feeling like you're only as valuable as your title, here's your reminder. You're not your job. You're so much more. The sooner you figure that out, the sooner you can start building a life that actually feels good, not just looks good on paper. So yeah, next time someone asks, what do you do? Component placement, just hit them with, I live life, baby, because that's the truth. 2. Being nice won't save you. Okay, time for some real talk. Being nice won't save you. Yeah, I said it. Society loves to tell us, be kind and good things will come to you. Spoiler alert. Being nice isn't a magic formula for success or happiness, and it's certainly not going to stop people from walking all over you. Being nice doesn't always mean being respected. In fact, sometimes it's a fast pass to getting used and ignored. So back in the day, I was the nicest person in the room, always saying yes, never rocking the boat, and guess what? I ended up getting steamrolled. People knew I wouldn't push back, so they'd pile extra work on me, interrupt me in meetings, and take advantage of my kindness. And did I get rewarded for being the nice one? Absolutely not. I just got more overwhelmed and angrier. Let me hit you with a truth bomb. Nice people often finish last because they don't set boundaries. I didn't want to upset anyone, and in return, I got no respect. Sound familiar? Look, I tried being Captain Nice, saving the world with my kindness, and you know what happened? I ended up with everyone's dirty laundry and zero thank yous. It's like you become the designated problem solver, but no one's solving your problems. Turns out, being nice doesn't make you a hero. It just makes you available for everyone else's convenience. And trust me, that cape gets heavy after a while. Now, don't get me wrong, kindness is important. But here's the controversial part. Too much niceness is a form of self-sabotage. Yep, I said it. When you're constantly bending over backwards for people, you're teaching them that your needs don't matter. And guess what? They'll believe you. Saying no doesn't make you a bad person, and setting boundaries doesn't make you selfish. It makes you smart. Because when you keep saying yes to everyone else, you're saying no to yourself. Here's the deeper lesson I've learned. Being nice is not the same as being authentic. For a long time, I thought I had to be agreeable and always say yes to be liked. But in trying to please everyone else, I was betraying myself. And trust me, that's a dangerous road. Being nice doesn't mean allowing others to disrespect you. True kindness starts with being kind to yourself. That means setting boundaries, saying no when you need to, and standing up for what you believe in, even if it ruffles a few feathers. I'll never forget the time I finally stood up for myself at work. I had this colleague who would constantly dump her tasks on me, knowing I wouldn't push back. One day, I snapped, politely of course, and said, "Sorry, I'm really swamped with my own work today. You'll have to figure it out." I was shaking, thinking the world would end. But guess what? The world didn't end. In fact, she stopped asking me to do her work. That one moment taught me that you can be firm without being mean, and still keep your dignity intact. So here's the thing. You don't have to stop being a nice person, but you've got to pair that niceness with a backbone. Be nice, but not at the expense of your sanity, because no one's handing out awards for being the nicest doormat. Kindness is powerful, but it's even more powerful when it comes with self-respect. Being nice won't save you, but being nice with boundaries will. So, next time you're about to say yes just to be liked, ask yourself, am I being kind, or am I just avoiding confrontation? The answer might surprise you. And remember, being nice doesn't mean being a pushover. It just means you know when to help and when to hand people their own problems. Trust me, they'll be fine. 3. Love isn't enough. All right, let's just cut the crap for a second. We've all grown up on this idea that love is all you need. Thanks, Hollywood. Thanks, Disney. I mean, how many times have we been fed that sweet little lie? Turns out, love, on its own, isn't enough. Yeah, I said it. And honestly, some people are gonna hate me for this one. Because we've been brainwashed to believe that if you just love someone enough, everything will magically work out. Like, all your problems, gone, your differences, smoothed over. But guess what? Love doesn't pay the bills. Love doesn't solve communication issues. And love sure as hell won't fix a toxic relationship. Let me get real with you for a second. I was once in a relationship where we loved each other, no doubt about that. We had the chemistry, the passion, the butterflies, but we couldn't communicate to save our lives. Every argument was a disaster, and we never worked through anything. I kept telling myself, but we love each other, so it'll get better. Spoiler, it didn't. It took me a long time to realize that love isn't some magical glue that holds everything together. Without respect, trust, and real communication, love is like duct tape on a sinking ship. Sure, it might hold for a while, but eventually it's going down. So let's break it down, shall we? Here are the things love can't fix. Different life goals. Bad communication. that one person who never does the dishes. Yeah, love doesn't stop you from wanting to strangle someone when they leave dirty dishes in the sink for the millionth time. But wait, I thought love could conquer anything. Sarcastic gasp. Newsflash, it can't, and that's okay. Love is important, but if you're banking on love alone to make a relationship work, you're in for a rude awakening. Here's where it gets spicy. Love doesn't always mean you should stay. Yeah, I said it. Sometimes you can love someone deeply and still have to walk away. Because love isn't enough to erase incompatible goals or fundamental differences. You can love someone and still be miserable with them. I know, it's not the fairy tale ending we all want, but this is real life, not a rom-com. People stay in toxic, unhappy relationships because they think, well, we love each other, so it'll work out eventually. No, Karen, it won't. If you're constantly fighting, if you don't trust each other, or if your values don't align, love isn't gonna fix that. It's like trying to cure a broken bone with a band-aid. I remember after that breakup, I was devastated. I kept thinking, but we loved each other, so why couldn't we make it work? And it hit me like a ton of bricks. Love isn't the problem. It's that we didn't have the tools or the compatibility to make it last. We didn't communicate. We didn't grow together. And love wasn't enough to fix those deeper issues. Here's the deeper truth. Love is a foundation, but it's not the whole building. You need trust, respect, communication, compromise, and yeah, even a little space sometimes. Love is powerful, but it's only one part of the equation. Relationships are work. They require effort, and sometimes, despite all the love in the world, they still don't work out. I know that sounds harsh, but it's also freeing. Love can exist even when you know you need to let someone go. You can love someone and still realize that they're not the right person for you. Love doesn't mean staying in a situation that's draining you or holding you back. And that doesn't make the love any less real. So yeah, love is great, but it's not the fairy tale cure for all your problems. Next time you're about to say, love will fix this, remember, love isn't a mechanic. It's more like a spark. You need other things to keep the fire burning. You need fuel, air, and some occasional, very necessary relationship therapy. And sometimes, you just need to walk away before you burn the whole house down. At the end of the day, love is a choice. It's about choosing each other every day, even when things get tough. But it's also about choosing what's best for yourself. Don't ever stay in a relationship out of fear that the love will fade if you leave. Love doesn't die because a relationship ends. Love is energy. It changes, it evolves, and sometimes it's better expressed from afar. So, if you're out there thinking, why isn't love enough? Just know you're not alone. Love isn't supposed to do all the heavy lifting. It's one part of a much bigger picture, and sometimes love's biggest lesson is knowing when to let go. All right. That's enough love talk for today. Go out there and love smart, not just hard. 4. Time doesn't care about your excuses. Let me hit you with something harsh but necessary. Time doesn't care about your excuses. Seriously, time is the ultimate savage. It just keeps ticking no matter how many reasons you come up with for why you haven't done the thing. Whether you're procrastinating, scared, or just straight up lazy, time is like, not my problem. Here's the thing, we all think we have more time than we do. I'll do it tomorrow, I'm too busy right now. Or my personal favorite, I'm waiting for the right time. Yeah, well, newsflash, the right time never shows up with a red carpet. And while you're waiting, time's over there like, better keep up, buddy, because I'm not slowing down for you. I used to be the king of excuses. There was this project I wanted to start, something I was passionate about. But guess what? Every day I had an excuse. I'm too tired from work. I'll start next week. I need to research a bit more. You name it, I said it. Weeks turned into months, and guess how much progress I made? None. Zero. I wasted so much time waiting for things to be perfect, and guess what? Time didn't wait for me. One day, I had this wake-up call. I'm not getting that time back. All the excuses I made didn't matter, because time just kept on ticking. And let me tell you, it felt like I had been slapped in the face by my own laziness. You ever feel like you're in this constant race against time? Like you're always behind, but somehow you're still making excuses while the clock is out here lapping you? It's ridiculous. Time's over here winning the marathon while you're still trying to tie your shoes. The truth is, time isn't this magical thing that waits for you to be ready. It's moving whether you're hustling or Netflix binging. And the most brutal part, time's like don't care, didn't ask, keep up. It's savage, but that's what makes it real. Okay, here's the controversial bit. We're not as busy as we pretend to be. Oof, yeah, I said it. Most of us aren't busy. We're distracted, scrolling social media, binge-watching shows, or just mentally checked out. We like to say we're too busy to chase our dreams, but in reality, we're just making excuses. And don't even get me started on, I don't have time. Listen, Beyoncé has the same 24 hours as you do. I know, she's got a whole team. But the point is, we all get the same amount of time each day, and it's about how we choose to spend it. Time isn't the problem. You are. I had this realization one day that I was always too busy to do the things that actually mattered. You know, like spending time with family, working on my passion projects, or just taking care of myself. I had all these excuses lined up, but the truth was, I just wasn't managing my time well. And you know who didn't care about my excuses? Time. I looked up one day and years had gone by. No joke. And I had nothing to show for it. Let me tell you, there's nothing more humbling than realizing you wasted years making excuses. But hey, better to learn it now than never, right? Here's the deeper lesson. Time is the most precious thing we have, and we waste so much of it waiting for the right moment, making excuses, or being too afraid to take action. Time doesn't care about your fears, your reasons, or your procrastination. It just keeps moving, whether you're ready or not. And here's the kicker. You can't get it back. Once time is gone, it's gone for good. And that's why it's so important to stop waiting, stop making excuses, and just start. Even if it's messy, even if you're scared, even if you're not ready. Because guess what? You'll never be fully ready. And time doesn't care. It's just ticking. So stop wasting time. If you've got a dream, chase it. If there's something you've been putting off, do it now. Because guess what? Time's not stopping for you, and there's no pause button on life. Trust me, if you don't make time for what matters, time will make the decision for you. And hey, let's be real. Time isn't your enemy, but it's definitely not your friend if you keep making excuses. So stop waiting for the perfect time and just go for it. You'll be surprised what you can accomplish when you stop letting time slip through your fingers. At the end of the day, time is the one thing we can't control. It moves forward, with or without us. But here's the good news. You can control what you do with it. You can decide right now to stop letting excuses steal your time, because life is short and the clock is ticking. So, if you're sitting there, waiting for the right time to make a change or start that project, this is your sign. Time isn't waiting for you, so stop waiting for it. Get out there and make the most of every second, because trust me, you'll never regret making the most of your time. And remember, time doesn't care about your excuses, so stop making them. Just do the thing. 5. Your health is everything. All right, let's get real for a second. Your health is everything. And yet, most of us treat our bodies like they're disposable, like we can just hit reset whenever we feel like it. Spoiler alert, that's not how it works. You can't trade in your body like a busted old car. Once things start breaking down, they stay broken, unless you start paying attention now. But hey, I get it. We've all been there, burning the candle at both ends, eating garbage because we're too busy, and somehow convincing ourselves we'll just fix it all later. Well, let me tell you something controversial. Later doesn't come until your body slaps you in the face with a wake-up call. I used to be that person, the one who said, I'll focus on my health after this deadline, or I'll start exercising next month. I thought I was invincible, like I could keep running on stress, caffeine, and processed food forever. And guess what happened? My body shut down. One day, I was so wiped out, I literally couldn't get out of bed. My energy was gone, my stress levels were through the roof, and I felt like absolute garbage. It was like my body went, "Oh, you want to ignore me? Cool, here's a little taste of what that feels like." So, there I was, realizing I had turned into a human potato. I decided, okay, time to get serious. And let me tell you, my first workout after years of neglect. It was like trying to lift a car with spaghetti arms. I thought I was gonna pass out from walking up the stairs. But here's the thing, I had been telling myself I was too busy to work out, too stressed to eat healthy. Turns out, I wasn't too busy. I was just making excuses because I didn't want to deal with it. The irony? The worse my health got, the less I could actually get done. So, in trying to save time by skipping workouts and eating junk, I was literally losing time because I felt like crap. All right, here's the controversial bit. Your health should be your number one priority. Not your job, not your deadlines, not even your relationships. If you're not healthy, you can't be there for anyone or anything else. And yet, we live in a society that glorifies burnout. You know what I'm talking about? Those Instagram posts like, hustle hard, sleep later, or team no days off. Let me tell you something, that's nonsense. If you collapse because you're overworked and unhealthy, guess what happens? Nothing. You don't magically get a reward for running yourself into the ground. In fact, you might just get a hospital bill instead. Newsflash, if you're dead tired all the time, you're not productive. You're just going through the motions like a zombie. And let's be real, zombies aren't exactly known for crushing their to-do lists. So after my health scare, I made a change. I started eating better, working out, nothing crazy, just small steps. And slowly but surely, I started feeling alive again. Like, actually awake, focused and more productive than I'd been in years. I realized that when you invest in your health, it pays off in every other area of your life. I wasn't just doing it for myself, I was doing it so I could be better in every role I play, as a friend, a partner, at work, everything. Trust me, if I can do it, anyone can. I was the king of bad habits. Now, I actually enjoy taking care of myself. And it's not because I'm some health nut, it's because I realized how much better my life is when I'm not running on fumes. Here's the deeper truth. You only get one body, and if you're not taking care of it now, you're setting yourself up for pain later. I'm talking burnout, stress-related illness, even chronic diseases. And the worst part? Most of us wait until something goes seriously wrong before we start paying attention. It's easy to ignore your health when you're young or when things feel fine. But I'm here to tell you, your health is the foundation of everything. If you don't have your health, nothing else matters. You can't hustle if you're too sick or tired to get out of bed. You can't be there for your loved ones if you're constantly run down. And you can't enjoy life if you're always battling stress or exhaustion. So, what's the takeaway? Don't wait for a health scare to start caring about your body. You don't have to become a fitness fanatic or eat kale with every meal. Just start paying attention. Take care of yourself. Move your body, eat a vegetable every once in a while. Your future self will thank you. And hey, I'm not saying you need to quit all the fun stuff. I'm still gonna have my pizza nights and lazy Sundays, but it's all about balance. Because when your health is in check, everything gets better. Your mood, your productivity, your relationships. And guess what? You'll actually have the energy to enjoy life instead of just dragging yourself through it. At the end of the day, your health is the most important asset you have. It's the foundation for everything else in your life. If you're constantly tired, stressed, or unhealthy, you're not living. You're just surviving. And life's too short to settle for just surviving. So, take care of your body. It's not about looking a certain way or hitting the gym 7 days a week. It's about respecting the fact that this is the only body you've got. And if you want to live a full, happy, and productive life, your health has to come first. All right, that's it for today's health PSA. Now, go drink some water, take a walk, and maybe lay off the energy drinks. Trust me, your future self will thank you. 6. The biggest regrets come from what you didn't do. All right, let's get this straight. The biggest regrets in life don't come from the mistakes you make. They come from the things you didn't do. Yeah, I said it. And no, I'm not just talking about the big stuff like I should have climbed Mount Everest or I should have asked that person out. I'm talking about all the little decisions we don't make because we're scared, lazy, or waiting for the perfect time. Spoiler alert, there's no perfect time. You know that feeling when you see someone else living the life you wish you had and you think, why didn't I do that? Well, guess what? That little pang in your chest, that's called regret. And it stings a hell of a lot more than failing at something. Look, I'm not just preaching here. I've lived it. I remember there was this one opportunity that came my way. It was risky, sure, but it was also a chance to do something I was really passionate about. But instead of jumping on it, I hesitated. I spent weeks coming up with reasons why I wasn't ready. Why it wasn't the right time. And before I knew it, the opportunity was gone. Let me tell you, that regret hits harder than any failure ever could. Because I wasn't upset about trying and failing. I was upset because I never even gave myself the chance to fail. And trust me, that's a whole different kind of regret. You know what's funny? We don't regret the things we tried and failed at nearly as much as we regret the things we talked ourselves out of. You ever notice that? No one lies awake at night thinking, I wish I hadn't gone on that adventure, or I really regret putting myself out there. Nope. It's always, why didn't I take that trip? Or why didn't I say yes to that opportunity? It's the things we didn't do that haunt us. And let's be real. We've all got a list of I should've's that we carry around with us. It's like emotional baggage. But the good news is, you don't have to keep adding to that list. All right, here's where it gets spicy. Playing it safe is overrated. Yeah, I said it. I know, I know. We're all taught that we need to have a plan, be cautious, think things through. But here's the thing. If you live your life only making safe choices, you're gonna end up in a very boring place. Safe doesn't get you anywhere exciting. Safe doesn't get you memories, it doesn't get you stories, and it sure as hell doesn't get you fulfillment. People think the worst thing that can happen is failing. Nah, the worst thing is getting to the end of your life and realizing you never even tried. Look, here's the controversial bit. Playing it safe is the fast track to regret. People aren't scared of failure, they're scared of what other people will think of their failure. So they play it safe. But guess what? The people who are out there doing awesome things, they're not playing it safe. They're taking risks, making mistakes, and collecting stories, not regrets. Let me be real with you. The moments I regret most in my life are the ones where I didn't take the leap. There was that time I didn't move to a new city because I was scared of leaving my comfort zone, or the time I didn't go after a passion project because it seemed too risky, Every time I played it safe, I lost an opportunity to grow, to experience something new, to live. But here's the thing, I learned from those regrets. Now, I'd rather try and fail than wonder what if for the rest of my life. And let me tell you, that mindset shift, it's freeing. It's like giving yourself permission to be bold, to be messy, and to live without regrets. Here's the truth. The regrets that stick with you aren't the ones about things you did. They're the ones about the things you didn't do, the conversations you didn't have, the dreams you didn't chase, the chances you didn't take. And you know what? Life's too short to keep holding back. At the end of the day, we don't regret our failures nearly as much as we regret our inactions. We regret not taking the risk to follow our passion. We regret not telling someone how we really feel. We regret not seeing the world when we had the chance. So here's my advice. Don't wait until it's too late. Don't let fear of failure or judgment or uncertainty hold you back from living the life you really want. Because, yeah, failure stings, but regret haunts you. So here's the plan. Stop hesitating, stop overthinking, and just go for it. Whether it's a big dream, a small adventure, or even a conversation you've been putting off, just do it. You don't want to look back in 10, 20, or 50 years and think, why didn't I? Trust me, it's better to have stories about things that didn't work out than regrets about things you never even tried. And hey, even if you fail, you're gonna have a killer story to tell. Way better than, I didn't do anything because I was scared. So get out there and make some bold, brave choices. The world's waiting for you. At the end of the day, life is a collection of moments. Some of those moments will be messy, some will be beautiful, and some will be straight up chaotic. But you know what? The only moments you'll regret are the ones you never allowed yourself to have. So, take the leap, make the move, say the thing, do the thing, because in the end, the biggest regrets aren't from what you tried and failed, they're from what you didn't do at all. All right, that's my wisdom for the day. Now go out there and do something that future you will thank you for. No more what-ifs, no more hesitation, just action. Trust me, you'll be glad you did. All right, my friends, that's it for today. Remember, life's too short to let fear, excuses, or what-ifs hold you back. Whether it's about taking care of your health, living without regrets, or ditching the things that don't serve you, it's all about making the moves that will bring you closer to the life you truly want. Because at the end of the day, you're in the driver's seat. You've got the power to make choices that matter, to take risks, and to create a life that's full of stories, not regrets. So go on, make that leap, start that project, or just take that small step towards something new. Trust me, future you will be doing a little happy dance for the bold choices you make today. And hey, if you liked this video and it made you think or laugh, don't forget to hit that like button, share it with someone who needs a little push, and of course, subscribe if you haven't already. We've got plenty more life lessons and laughs coming your way. All right, that's all for now. Get out there and make some magic happen, because your best life is waiting for you. No more excuses, no more delays. Go live it.